Inbound routes are required for the phone system to be able to receive phone calls. Each trunk that has been added to the system needs to have its own separate inbound routes configured. To begin, log into the system, go to the Extensions Trunk option, and then select Inbound Routes. This will show a list of all the current inbound routes for the selected trunk. There is a drop-down box towards the top of the screen that you can use to select which trunk you want to configure routes for. Right now, the selected trunk is one that consists of several analog phone lines. Analog trunks do not support direct dial numbers or DIDs, so they will only ever have one inbound route configured. If you select the option to edit the trunk, you can see that the pattern box is grayed out because it does not apply to this type of trunk. The caller ID box can be used to specify calling numbers that can use this route. For general purpose inbound routes, this won't typically be used. The next section includes settings that apply to routes from any kind of trunk. Depending on the firmware version of the system, some of these options may not be available. Disable route is self-explanatory. Prepend trunk name and prepend user-defined name allow you to add additional caller ID name information to inbound calls using this route. This would typically be used if people need to answer the phone differently depending on the phone number that is called. Prepend trunk name adds the trunk name to the caller ID name, and prepend user-defined name allows you to add custom text. Prepend trunk name overrides the user-defined name, so if it is selected, you cannot use the prepend user-defined name option. The alert info box allows you to specify a custom ringtone to be used for calls that use this route. You can either use the built-in ringtones, which only apply to Grandstream phones, or you can specify a custom value. If you use a custom value, the phones will need to be configured with this so that they are aware of which ringtone to use when they receive the call. The Allow to Seamless Transfer setting allows you to specify extensions which, if they are busy and have a mobile number configured, will allow the call to ring the mobile phone number that's set on the extension. Inbound Multiple Mode allows you to enable a feature code, which is specified in the Set Global Inbound Mode in the Main Inbound Routes section, that allows users to manually change the inbound route. This can be useful if a company has varied hours and wants to be able to activate an after-hours behavior manually. The default destination box under default mode is where you configure where the call is routed when it uses this inbound route and is in the default mode, if you have inbound multiple mode enabled. There are quite a few options for this, with the most commonly used ones being extension, IVR, ring group, and queue. After you select the type of destination, the box on the right will allow you to pick which one to use. In this case, there is only one IVR configured on the system, but if there were more, they would be listed here. The Time Conditions section allows you to add alternate routes based on various time options. The most common use for this setup is to allow for different routing for calls either after hours or on holidays. When you select the Add button, you will then need to specify the time condition that will apply. In this case, I will select out of office and holiday, which means that if the time matches either out of office or a holiday, it will use this route instead of the default destination. Enabling Inbound Multiple Mode activates the Mode 1 tab, which functions the same way as the default mode tab, but will only be active if the feature code for it is dialed on a phone. Back on the main inbound routes screen, you can configure the inbound multiple mode settings by selecting Set Global Inbound Mode. This allows you to either enable or disable it set which mode the system is currently in, specify the feature codes to be used for setting which mode the system is in, and also specify an extension number that can be added as a BLF key to a phone so that there is a visual indicator of which mode the system is currently in. I'm now going to switch to a SIP trunk, as the inbound routes for these, as well as PRI trunks, have some additional options and require some additional configuration compared to routes used for analog trunks. If you select the option to add a route, you can see that the pattern box is no longer grayed out. This is because SIP trunks support DIDs and require you to specify a number pattern so that the system can identify which route to use when a particular number is called. Hovering over the pattern text will show the different options and variables that can be used in these patterns. This is the most basic pattern and can be used as a catch-all since it matches any number. More specific patterns can also be used. In this case, the route will only match one number. Different providers may send a different number of digits to the system for the DID. In this case, it is sending 10, but some may send 7 or even 4. The rest of the options are the same as an analog trunk, with the exception of under default destination, you now have the option to route by DID. This can be useful if you have a large block of contiguous DIDs and a large number of extensions. Say you have a DID range with the last four digits going from 4101 to 4200, and an extension range of 1001 to 1100. Instead of creating a rule for each DID and extension, you can specify a pattern that includes all of the possible DIDs. You can then specify how many digits will need to be stripped from the number, as well as what, if any, digits need to be prepended. In this example, we want to keep the last three digits and then add a 1, so we configure it to strip 7 digits from the beginning of the number and then prepend a 1 to the remaining digits. The number that results from this will now match one of our extensions. One last thing to mention is that you are allowed to have overlapping DID patterns and that the order of the inbound routes does not matter. When evaluating which route to use, the system goes from most specific to least specific, so that a route which has no variables in it and is an exact match for a number will be used before a route that has a few variables in it with specific matches for some of the numbers, followed by the catch-all route which only contains variables.